Our line, we are here live, Espresso Sesh. Varros,
what's up?
There's a couple of the Blue Hours with Matthew, the Blue Hours. Right, cool. Let me just put this guy on the. Back. Okay. So today is gonna be a song salon. When it, okay, we are back here. Yeah, when it's on Wi-Fi. Okay. Okay. This is my 10th broadcast. Congratulations. Good. This is the 10th broadcast.
The
10th. Okay.
When I was a little child.
Okay. So you know, doing radio, it's not it's not like just oh you go on the radio that you play music, but it's also like keeping track of playlists. Live performance, technical stuff. Okay, Raul and Luca and Zeni. Okay, thank you for listening. It's gonna be a nice show with live music, so stay tuned. We're about to start. Okay, this mic is cool. Let's put this over here. So, full studio play. I got mama as well. Okay, it's Dennis. All the way from Istanbul, and there's Alfio all the way from Lentini, and there is Ciro all the way from Lentini. Right. Cool. So after this song we go. Okay, I'll meet you guys. Okay. Let's plug this song too. You are listening to the Espresso Sesh. Lelo, ciao Ciro, okay? Cool. Cool. 2 minutes, there we go. Okay. So there's gonna be some live music today. Ciao Lino, and there's a great setup rig here in this little space. In this little space, gonna fit like five people, one radio show. Look at that, 12 people watching, 5 people. So for a total of 17 people, wow. Yo. So many people. Okay. Okay, 1 minute, there we go. So your mic is going through this over there. Okay. When I turn the mic on, there is the speaker has bypass, so
okay.
Don't worry if you don't listen to music, but okay. 9, 8, and yes, here we are, Best Frequencies Forever, Espresso Sesh. Hello, can you hear me? Mic 1, mic 2. There is Alberto Balsam on the background. All right, here we are. Espresso Sesh, best frequencies forever. I cannot hear my voice, but probably yes. Okay, around here. Okay, we are live, so things are like, what you see is what you get, what you hear is what you get. So, welcome guys, let's start the show, okay? Song Salon episode today.
Yeah.
With Heather Pearson, hello.
Hi, thanks for having us.
Hello, welcome.
Thank you.
Andrew Varros.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me.
And Teresa and Matt from the Blue Hours.
Hey.
And you are here, okay?
Thanks.
Hello, welcome guys. So today we are featuring this Song Salon episode. That is, what is Song Salon? Heather, like, probably you are the best one to describe us what
sure.
it's all about.
Yeah, so Song Salon is something that I created for my clients. I'm a vocal coach, and I work with a lot of really talented singer-songwriters and bands, and two of them are here with me, Andrew and Teresa. So Song Salon is basically an intimate gathering of artists coming together and presenting work that's in progress or completed, but just kind of sharing the work that they're creating at any given time.
So it's kind of like an open mic concept, but it's not really like public? So.
Yeah, it's not public, and it's more, we kind of created like a nice close-knit community within the artists that I work with, and because they don't always get to meet each other all the time, you know, everybody's busy playing their shows, recording their albums, etc., and, you know, I was just like, I work with so many amazing people, I want them to know each other, and sometimes collaborations happen from it, and also it's just, it's a good chance for everybody to just kind of try stuff, you know, maybe it's not fully formed yet, or maybe someone has a question of like, I have two options for this bridge that I'm writing, what do you think, or do you like this key, or what can I do better, or I just need to play this because I haven't played it in front of people yet. So it's just kind of become this open forum and creative discussion, and just a really good a good camaraderie too. It's
yeah.
fun. We have a good time as well, right? Because music is fun,
yeah.
right?
Cool. So it's a way to like share your creation and also a way to like perform your own songs.
Yeah, and workshop it.
Workshop it, like break the ice, like with performance and
uh-huh.
Like create, like network with other creative people. Cool. So
yeah.
nice. And today we're gonna do like Song Salon at the Espresso Sesh.
Yes.
So we're gonna do some this performance. We're gonna do it live.
Yeah.
On the radio. No. So that's really amazing. No. Because we have to share this time. We are sharing broadcasting.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So
cool.
We're having a whole new little element involved, which is really fun.
Cool. Okay. Let's before like the performance, let's have a little talk. No, let's talk about like. So you've been doing vocal coaching since a while now, no?
Yeah.
And
probably about like 13 years now.
13 years now.
Yeah.
Okay. And you came from like a background of like performer, like with bands and recording and stuff. And now you're focusing mostly on like sharing your knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
With other people and help them out, kind of like to.
Yeah,
I'm guessing. No, it's better than speak
that's
about.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Thank you.
Yeah. So basically, I mean, I still write and perform a little bit, and that's probably going to increase as time goes forward. But yeah, with my vocal coaching, I'm really passionate about helping singers alleviate the issues that come about when you're doing a lot of live performing or recording. So sometimes people get fatigued from doing a bunch of shows and having to sing really hard every night. Or maybe you're in the middle of a recording and you wrote something and it was easy when you wrote it, but then you actually are doing vocal takes and tracking and things aren't working as easily and seamlessly as you want and you don't know what to do. So that's where I come in. You know, not only do I help people with vocal warm-ups and workouts, but I'll go in the studio and help them when they're tracking and you know, nail a take if it's not going smoothly, and or prep them for tours or just a string of shows.
What you were telling me this before, that you also work with bands like on tour, like what's the band, the Third Eye Blind?
I've worked with Third Eye Blind and Geographer and some other great people, and yeah, it's really, it's a lot of fun, and I'm just happy to get to be a part of the process and just have an answer maybe when somebody needs one, you know, because it's a lot to put yourself out there as an artist, and there's a lot of pressure, and you know, you need a good team behind you.
Yeah, and also, you know, this make me think that like vocal coaching is it's for everyone, not just for somebody who is starting and is not confident, but it's even for somebody who is already out there and performing and touring.
Oh, absolutely.
So it's something that is some help that can be beneficial for everyone, no? Not just,
yes.
cool. And I'm glad that you brought to the Espresso Sesh like two of your like students, but they are like a great performer, and I can't wait to see them.
I feel like they're my colleagues. I mean, we all learn from each other.
Yeah,
though,
no, that's why, you know, like I say like with bragging.
My community.
Okay. Yeah, and they're gonna perform, and like for the first time actually at the studio, we have like an electronic rig with a drum machine and synth and like drums, and we have keyboards, we have guitars, so you know, it's gonna be
a lot of equipment. We're doing a show. We're doing a real show.
We're doing a real show. Okay. Yes. Cool. Before the live music, let's introduce Andrew.
Yeah.
Andrew, so...
What's up?
How's it going? Welcome to BFF.fm Espresso Sesh.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah.
I'm super excited.
So let's introduce yourself. Like, you don't have any recordings yet. You are working on some music.
I've been recording a lot lately, and I'm actually working on an EP at the end of March, so it's been very much this whole year recording and writing and getting things together, all that stuff.
Cool. I heard you performing, and you have like a nice like vocal tone, like very unique, very like kind of like not that many people like sing your like range, your chord. And you're gonna perform something on piano and vocals, no?
Yeah, doing like a bunch of acoustic piano stuff, cool. A few songs, so really cool.
Cool, yeah. And how you started with music, and when you started like with Heather, like doing the lesson and stuff?
I've pretty much been singing and playing my whole life, but it wasn't until around when I left college, as anything, relationships and heartbreak spurred me into music, and I kind of fell into writing to be able to express things that I couldn't express, and I just grew to love it, and it's become a craft for me that I am extremely passionate about, and I think that connecting raw emotion is something that everyone obviously can relate to, and it transcends like culture or language or really any place that you are as a human being, and so that's something that inspires me constantly, is being able to affect people through my craft, and I love sharing that. And so with Heather, I've been working with her now for like 2.5 years.
Yeah,
it feels like so much longer. She's seriously a vocal goddess.
Okay. I'll take it.
And like, it's, yeah, I love it. I'm so very grateful and blessed that I am able to work with you, and that I've met amazing musicians and artists like Teresa through her studio space. And the song salons are really awesome because it's like a connective experience from what Heather said, like colleagues, really. Mm-hmm. And so, I'm very grateful that I can be a part of your studio.
Thank
and work
you.
With you.
Same. Yeah.
Cool. And can't wait to hear your music live, Andrew. Okay, Teresa.
Hey.
Hello. Okay. I hear you. Try again. Say.
Hello. It's okay.
Yeah. Probably it's better if you talk on this guy. Yeah, on this guy.
Switch.
swing it over?
Yes. Good. Thank you. Perfect. Yeah, perfect. Okay, let's do also, let's switch this camera right there so even Matt can be in the frame. Are you? Yes. I need to hire a cameraman here. Are you in the frame? Okay. It's kind of odd. Anyways, so Teresa, you have I've seen you have like a background as a musician, classical guitarist, and very good stuff, I see. And you have like a Filipino heritage.
Yeah, my dad's actually from the Philippines.
From the Philippines, and also in your music as well. Because Canto Filipino, you released like an album called Canto Filipino, no? It's a guitar solo album. I think 2010, something like that. Cool. And since then, I mean, you're doing something different. I guess you're still playing guitar, no? And still performing as a guitarist. But also with Matt, you guys have a band called the Blue Hours. That kind of like combines, for the little few I've seen, combines the classical element with electronic music and pop, if can be like a description. And I've seen like a little making of, you guys released an EP, and I've seen this making of this EP, and you guys have like traditional folkloristic instruments. There was like a kind of like a jew harp.
Oh yeah, the jew harp. Yeah. The Philippines.
Okay.
So yeah.
And I've seen some bells.
The kulintang. Okay. The pot gongs from Philippines.
So you guys combine like classical instrument like violins. There is like a upright bass, a cello. With beats, the synthesizer, drum machine, and
it's kind of
classical guitar.
Yeah.
Cool, and actually the texture, the sound is great. This camera is so bad. One second. we have a nice ceiling, but you know, it's a beautiful ceiling, but you know, okay. Yeah, so you guys released an EP with like combining all these elements together, and in this nice, like the combination, the final, the sound is great. So in my opinion, no. So I can't wait to listen to you guys. Let's do this. Let's play another song, so we have time to set up. And you guys started with the performance, no? So the Blue Hours. I want you to talk about this project. Came out before you perform.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because I was telling everything myself.
Yeah. Now,
thank you. But you know, in your own words, it would be even nicer. No, like you know.
Yeah.
Please.
Well, So we both trained in classical music, and a few years ago, I started writing songs, and I had a mentor actually who I worked with on my previous CD of Filipino music, and he taught me all about the music from the Philippines, and then he passed away. And then I think that was kind of a catalyst for me to kind of go in a direction that felt more like me, sort of, like where I was coming from, like the influences I grew up with, including Filipino music. So, and that's when I found Heather, and she's been amazing, and the community of the Song Salon has been really an important way for me to grow and try out new songs I've written and get feedback, and it's just been this incredibly supportive and amazing experience to be a part of, and I'm also really grateful that I've had a chance to know Heather and work with her and meet Andy and everyone who's awesome. So
So you guys started the project, the Blue Hours project, like that was the catalyst, the moment that your mentor passed away, you know? But you guys like meet each other, and you guys have that vision like about the music to do, or like just like some ideas, some draft song that the
It's kind of funny. So I started with more playing guitar and singing, and then we kind of gradually started adding in these electronic elements and sampling things, you know, to incorporate some of the Filipino instruments, which we couldn't necessarily play live with just the two of us all the time. And so it just kind of grew into this other sound over time, I think, with incorporating the other things. Yeah.
It's nice multi-layered sound, but it's very nice, like good taste and great balance. So I can't wait to listen to it live. Okay, you're listening to Espresso Session, BFF, Best Frequencies Forever, and today we have an episode featuring Song Salon with Heather Pierce, Andrew Varros, and the Blue Hours with Teresa and Matthew. And let's play one song here. I got line up from Thundercat, and then let's get ready for some live performance. BFF.fm. Okay, the camera. Okay, we got Luca and Lino. The cameraman is not good. Okay, stay tuned. We're gonna do some live now performance. But first, damn change. So let's do this. Okay. Yeah, kind of. Okay, so this one. The BlueHours.com about to perform live. This song. 1 minute and a half. What do you guys perform? What song? It's called?
Monochrome Dreams.
Money?
Monochrome Motto.
Monochrome Dreams, okay, yeah. I'm writing a playlist here, so.
Oh, okay. Live BFF.fm Espresso Sesh. The Blue Hours are gonna perform Monochrome Dreams. Yes.
Monochrome dreams.
The Blue Hours Live, BFF.FM Espresso Session. Cool, yeah. So I see you guys build up like melodies, like overlaying elements. Cool. You want to play another one, Reda,
sure.
After this?
Yeah, this next one's called Electric Prophet, and it's about technology addiction.
Okay.
That myself and everyone else
have. Cool. So it's called, say again the name, please.
Electric Prophet.
Electric Prophet.
Yeah.
Okay, live at BFF.FM, the Blue Hours. It's okay, we are here, BFF.fm, Espresso Sesh. What you hear is what you get, and you are live, also what you see is what you get.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, you can always blame the camera.
I'm going to blame the MIDI controller. So.
No, it's all good, actually. We didn't rehearse this. You guys came here and played, so we are still like a work in progress. Even the game has to be...
That's a
sound
slower.
Yeah, that's the point, yeah.
Okay,
cool. Yeah, okay, so...
Try
again. Wow, that was nice. Like, yeah, with, kind of so like with the vocoder kind of Kraftwerk ish.
Mm-hmm. Laurie Anderson Kraftwerk.
Yeah, with the. So you guys like are doing this live, everything right now, like processing the vocals, like playing the parts, drums and mm-hmm. melodies.
Yeah, that's why sometimes there's like the technological glitch. But cool, you know, no, you work with it, I guess.
No, it's cool to see that the, like you guys with like a classical background, mm-hmm. now you are like taking like the, it's like they say, like you learn the rules and then you break them, no?
Definitely, yeah.
So you completely like, you know, like finding your own sound and like daring to like cross the boundaries, no? And mm-hmm. like process the vocals, process everything and find your own way. Cool. Pretty awesome, thanks. Guys. Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.
Cool. So you're listening to the Blue Hours. They are performing here live, and you can get an EP from them. It's called the Blue Hours EP. Huh?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Their website, thebluehours.com. You can see that with the reflect. Bluehours.com. Check them out. They have a Bandcamp page. We always support Bandcamp for their policy with artists and sales. You guys have another one?
Yeah.
Lineup?
Yeah, we have two more, but we do one more. Or
yeah, one more, two more, yes. Please go for it.
Cool. Okay.
What are you guys playing?
This one's called Princess.
Princess.
And it's actually kind of based on the Filipino version of the Ramayana.
Okay.
Sita. Filipino version.
Princess, the Blue Hours, live, BFF.fm.
Always be mine.
Wow. Princess Live BFF.fm, the Blue House. Out of curiosity, so how you guys compose the song? Like, you write the lyrics, you bring it to Matt, or like with the melody? How is the process?
Usually I'll kind of like figure out a little vibe first, either some sort of an instrument generally, and then I'll kind of sing a melody over it, or I'll steal a little Filipino folk melody, you know, or get some inspiration that way. So I usually have some kind of a track. Then I'll come with the lyrics, and then Matt adds usually bass and some drums.
Mm-hmm. Because also you play the bass, the upright bass, the cello.
Upright bass.
Electric bass. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
And here, like, you are sequencing everything and playing the drum machine and the synthesizer and the drums. So cool.
Yeah, Tiny Telephone has been really amazing too in formulating the synth stuff, because they have so much amazing
vintage gear. Yes, they have so much good gear. Yeah, and also if you guys have a chance to check out the website, thebluehours.com, there is a video about the making of the EP. It's pretty nice. Okay, let's play another one.
Yeah,
please.
Time. It's okay.
Right. What are you guys gonna play?
This song's called Run.
It's called Run, and you're gonna play the guitar as well.
Yeah.
Okay. We fit. Yes. So what's the name of the song again? Sorry,
The name of the song is called Run.
Called Run. Okay, yeah, my memory
like
is
running away.
Okay, Run the Blue Hours by BFF.fm.
Thank you.
was very good, guys. And the Blue Hours, like BFF.fm. Cool, yeah, I can, in this track I can hear more the classic influence and like cinematic vibes, like kind of like a down tempo trip hop, but like pretty cool guys. And you gotta say that when you guys play live, there are two more elements.
Mm-hmm.
There is a violin.
Violin, yeah. And he was here in spirit.
Yeah, it's really cool. And also, you know, like it's would be kind of difficult to fit.
Like, yeah,
you
know,
yeah, no, no, like, yeah. Right, we stay cozy. Yeah.
Can stand on the
cool, you guys are great. Like, a pleasure to have you here performing. Okay. So, you have another song ready or not?
We don't have a live one, but.
Like, okay. Yeah, no, because also I would like to, you know, ask you for the influence, the music that is influential for you, no? So if you have some, like, song, like one or two songs that are influential.
Yeah, we have one.
Closer to
LP.
The mic, please, because this
sorry,
is.
Sorry, we have an LP. Do you have a. Grab the LP. This one.
Huh?
You can't play LPs.
Oh, yeah, I mean, we can, but we need to move a little, yeah,
but,
okay.
If not, we brought LPs, so I guess it's...
It's LP, but probably we can find on YouTube and play
it
over.
Sure.
Yeah? So what you brought, and actually, you know what, if you speak on this mic,
okay.
Because there is it's processed,
that
one.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
So,
cool.
I think one of the songs that I find to be very inspiring is Laurie Anderson's Oh Superman. Because she uses vocoder, and it's actually, I think, kind of an homage to a classical composer as well. And I just love how minimalistic it is, and she's just such an inspiring person and artist. She's, you know, not necessarily a powerhouse singer, but she's really creative, I think, and she kind of pulls a lot of elements, so I find that inspiring.
Cool. So we're going to listen to Laurie Anderson, or Superman, and this is your pick as like an inspirational music. Thank you so much, guys, for performing, and check them out, thebluehours.com. Their music is available to download. They have digital downloads, they have a CD, and limited edition CD, and follow them because I guess you guys are in the process of recording new songs, no?
Yeah, we've got them recorded, and we're trying to fundraise to release the CD.
The CDs.
Uh-huh.
You have any show coming up?
Almost.
Almost. So
we might be playing the Hotel Utah on March 25th, but we're kind of finalizing that, to be honest. So.
Okay, so if you're listening to this and you wanna at them performing, please do it because they are awesome. You have like an example here live at the session. Okay, thank you so much, the Blue Hours, Matt and Teresa. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us. Thank you so much.
And let's listen to Laurie Anderson or Superman, their pick. And we're gonna play some more live music here. PFF.fm. Okay, stay tuned. Here we're gonna be more live performance. While the Blue Hours are tearing it down. Thank you, Matt. Awesome stuff. Let's do this for 1 second. Check this out. They are changing the. Yo. Yo.
I'm not home right now, but if you want to leave a message, just start talking with the sound of the tone.
You wanna go out there? Or you wanna enjoy the fall? You want to perform again?
Sure, I'll perform again.
Are you there?
Yeah.
Are you coming home?
We are still live in the studio. We have a set change. The Blue Hours were performing first. By the way, Blue Hours, you have like applause. Pietro say applause. Another, like, I think it was Lino, say like really great. Some feedback, like visual feedback. Yeah.
Thank you.
That is going. Yeah, you want to say something like that?
Thanks for listening.
Check them out. Check them out. The Blue Hours.
.com.
All right. Who's coming next, Heather?
Next we have Andrew with Varros music.
Varros
so,
music.
So yeah, so we have to set up a keyboard for him. So
yeah,
just like 1 second.
1 second.
Not too long.
Not too long. Yeah. No, stay tuned. Look at my face and look at my hand and say hello, hello. Cool. Okay.
And I said, okay, who is this really? And the voice said, this is the
hand.
Good.
The
this is the hand.
Long enough, you can give it to me, I'll plug it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
keep it live, we keep it real, Espresso Sesh, and getting there with the setup. We are getting there, so be patient, a little patient. Enjoy the sweet vocals with the it's kind of like a little feedbacky, like there's like a static on the back. But you can go ahead and use that. Yeah.
Okay, let me just.
We are setting up for more live performance, setting up a digital piano. Varros is coming and playing next. In the meanwhile, VarrosMusic.com. And after Laurie Anderson, check this out. From Atlanta, Georgia, close. Ciao, Luca. Getting there.
I think I have to hold this
one.
Is that okay?
Yeah, if you want all this, yeah, if you don't mind, yeah. Okay, cool. Let me see.
We have to do.
Yes. Okay. You get it there. Introduce you and then okay. Song Salon episode. except the guys that were studying me.
Yeah.
That's good. Pros. Pros.
Yeah.
Pros. Yeah. Yes, here we are back again. Best fragrances forever. Espresso session. Whoo! Okay, now after some good times with the band The Blue Hours, we're gonna feature some live music from Andrew, aka Varros.
Yeah.
Andrew, on the mic, please.
What's up?
Okay, welcome, Andrew.
Thank you for having me.
So, Varros music, Varros. So,
yes.
What are you gonna perform to us?
This first song I'm gonna play is called Only One in Love, and it is actually the first song I ever wrote. And so, it's had quite a journey. It's been recorded like a few times, and it's been pretty much 4 or 5 years since I first started writing this song, and the song kind of is like the beginning of my journey as an artist, so excited to play it for you.
Cool, and let's play, let's go for it.
Yeah.
So, you know, the piano is gonna, is on speakers, no?
Yeah.
So we're not going, okay.
Yeah.
So maybe we're gonna try to put this one close, okay. So, Varros Live.
Huh? We can turn off the speaker on the piano.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, cool. So we're gonna listen to Varros performing. Say again the name of the song, man, like it's... like my short-term memory is bad.
It's all good. Sometimes I can't remember what I have for breakfast.
Yeah, it happens. Welcome to my life. Yeah, like it happens every day.
Only One in Love.
Only One in Love.
Only One in Love, live, BFF.fm, Varros.
I need to sort things out.
my heart is over my head, and I need only one in love. Yeah, I need only one in love. Am I wrong? Am I right? Are the games we play just all inside my mind?
FM Espresso Sesh. Okay. Cool. Your approach is mostly like a singer-songwriter, like naked music, let's call it, like for now, no? Like
yeah.
Vocals and piano. And so you are in the process of, I know that you are in process of recording some music.
I am.
Are you keeping that minimal also on the recording, or are you adding instruments?
It's going to be a combination of minimalism. I'm a huge fan of minimalism in music, especially vocally. I love being able to bring out like the raw emotion behind a piece, and I grew up just playing piano and performing on just piano, and so for me, I feel like it allows me to weave in and out of this like emotional experience. And so for the EP, a lot of it is going to be kind of minimal, but there's going to be a lot of Motown and soul influences, especially with horns and guitar and bass lines and hard sick drum beats and synths as well. I've been moving more and more into electro soul music, and so kind of creating a dark etherealness behind everything is the goal of the EP project.
Cool. Yeah, and so you're in process of recording an EP these days.
Yeah.
It's going to be like five songs?
It's going to be five songs.
So
one of the songs is done. I just finished recording. And then the rest of the songs I'm doing with Tiny Telephone. And so it'll be a really fun project.
Cool. Can't wait to see when it's going to be out. So I think this is one song that is going to be in the EP.
Yeah, this is one of the ones that's going to be in there.
But this is the a preview version.
Yeah.
Like just like naked music, like vocals and piano.
Exactly.
Okay, cool. Varros here, BFF.fm, Espresso Session. Are you going to play another one?
Next? Yeah, this next song is a cover. I grew up on a lot of soul music. And this song is by an artist named Minnie Riperton. It's called Loving You.
Okay, Loving You, live at BFF.fm. Varros.
Whew.
Yeah. So, one second. If we plug, there's a headphones out on that. Yeah, but you know, if you put, or put the volume a little higher. Yeah, on the keyboard,
mm-hmm.
It's all the way. Okay, cool, ready to go, set. So, Loving You, live at BFF.fm, Varros.
With you is all I wanna do. everything that I do is out of loving you. La 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 la.
Live song salon at the Espresso Sesh.
Yeah.
Cool. So I can tell you get inspired, like feeling, emotion, are mostly like your source number one for inspiration. Talking about music, no?
Yeah, I love artists like Amy Winehouse or Etta James or Otis Redding. Are huge influences to me, and I love just the way that they project this vulnerable, raw emotion through their voice, and it's something that like has always really impacted me, as with music does. I mean, that's the goal, right? But for me, that's what I think is beautiful, and I think that it's okay to not be afraid of emotion and to express yourself. And sometimes that comes out as a little bit crazy, but like,
yeah.
It's beautiful, and it's the beauty of imperfection that I think is really important.
Yeah, cool. And actually, this is something that is kind of like the beauty of imperfection, or like the things that are like done, like that,
yeah.
Not like in your face, not like this live show here, not like Espresso Sesh itself. You know, it's like what you hear is what you get. So we like
yeah.
the imperfection. We like to do things like no matter what, no, and learn from mistakes. And actually, you know, I have like a long time ago that the magic happens outside the comfort zone. So if
yeah.
we don't dare, if we don't like really like put ourselves in a like not comfortable spot, we never experience the magic. So
exactly.
it's like be like there, like do it, no, and see. Where you can get, or just be amazed by.
Exactly.
Actually, you know, this thing was in the Blue Hours. They have a video, like a promotional video, no? And they were talking about the failing, no? Like, don't be afraid to fail, because, like, when you fail, like, you get up. Like, you fell to the ground, but you,
yeah.
you know, like, you get up, man, you know? And then, like, you fell before, so you know what it is, no? It's not a big deal. But
exactly.
if you don't fail once, like, you don't know, you always be afraid of failing, you know, and then you don't do shit, you know, like, you do shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, we can say shit on the yeah, yeah, yeah. It's not FCC, yet, so we can do it.
Yeah, I completely agree. Like, I think that failing is a humbling experience, and it's an experience in which we grow.
Yeah.
And, like, that's the beauty of it.
It's a formative experience, yes. So, while we are here, like, we're not gonna fail, we're gonna win, but we're gonna play another song, okay?
Well, speaking of imperfection, get ready. this song, I haven't played in a while, but I really love it. My music is inspired by my personal experiences in love and relationships, and that means really anything like friends, family, lovers, everything. And this song came out of a time when I was in a very dark place and in a very bad relationship. And it's all about letting go and moving forward. And so I hope you guys enjoy it. It's called I Can't Stay.
I Can't Stay, Varros Live, BFF.FM.
Let's make sure I get the chords.
Original songs, cool, you sing your art out, like, with this composition, like, with your performance, like, stories of, like, real life, like, put it there, like, so you're like, brave, double brave, like, to bring your own life and sing about it, no?
Thank you.
Thank you, Heather, also for holding the microphone.
I know. We need to get my arm workout today.
I'm getting my arm workout.
Cool. So check him out, varrosmusic.com. Also on Instagram, varrosmusic. And he's in the process of recording an EP, and it's gonna, like, what about the timeline? You can say...
I'm recording it in March, so it'll probably be out sometime in the summer. Probably either May or June.
Either May or June, just check him out, follow him, and
I have updates and everything on my Instagram and on my website, and all links through there, so...
Cool. Did you bring any song that was influential for you?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, what do you got? What
did you bring?
YouTube. Huh? Yeah.
The first song is "You Know I'm No Good" by Amy Winehouse.
Okay.
Like I said before, Amy Winehouse is a huge influence on me vocally, stylistically, and also just how she writes about, like, real shit. Like, it's her life, and she's laying it all bare for you. And this song is a good example of what I find beautiful in music, and she's an incredible artist.
Cool, so we're gonna listen to that. Right now we are BFF.fm, so it's Varros pick number one, Amy Winehouse, "You Know I'm No Good." Probably you heard this song, but it's always good to listen to again. And we're gonna get ready for some new live here, so stay tuned, BFF.fm. Thank you, Andrew. Thank you, Varros. Check him out, Varros Music. Amy Winehouse. Okay. Cool.
Good job.
Thanks.
Varros Music. Yeah. Okay. And they got Nick Rouse. Hello, brother. So. Hold on a second, because we're going to have the last performance here. Oh, getting ready for the third performance here. And we play after Amy Winehouse. We got this Sylvan Esso, new band from North Carolina. From North Carolina, all the way. Song Salon episode. Now Heather Pierce is coming in the house. You guys getting ready? Yes, we are back again, BFF.FM Espresso Session, Espresso Sesh live with Song Salon. So we've been featuring so far the Blue Hours and then Varros. Now it's time to Heather Pierce, the originator, the original instigator of the Song Salon. So we talk about the Song Salon.
Yeah.
We briefly talk about like your vocal coaching. Uh-huh. But now we can't wait to hear you performing some.
No? Thank you. Sure. Yeah.
What are you gonna perform to us?
So I have two tunes. The first one is one of mine.
Okay.
And I mean, it may still be a work in progress, but I mean, this really. This whole thing, me even playing guitar for myself, this is really a product of Song Salon for me.
Okay.
Because I've been a musician my whole life, and I've sung many different genres in many incarnations, different bands, etc. And I could always play like a little piano, maybe a tiny bit of guitar, whatever. But I did feel a bit at the mercy of other musicians to perform. You know, I was never comfortable accompanying myself, and So when I started Song Salon, a lot of my clients would come in and they, you know, you don't have to be the greatest guitar player in the world to get something out live. And for some reason, I just held myself to this crazy high standard of like, well, I've always been really comfortable singing. And I thought, if you're not as good as that on an instrument, then like, don't do that on stage. But finally, I was like, screw it. And so...
You find some courage and perform
on
the guitar.
Yeah. And, you know, like I said, I'm not Jimmy. I love him, but that's not what I do. And so it's not perfect, and that's fine. And being in process is really what I'm all about. And like Andrew was saying, and like we saw with the Blue Hours too, you know, sometimes you have to start the song over and it's not that big a deal. It doesn't mean you suck. So,
yeah.
So anyway.
But it's good. It's good also to like to challenge yourself.
Yeah,
and,
of course.
Like we said before, no, like step into the.
Yeah. Step into the ring.
Step into the ring. Yeah. Okay. So while you set up the microphone here in this tiny studio, BFF.fm.
Tiny, tiny. Awesome
thanks
studio.
To the secret alley that hosts us two studios of BFF.fm.
Yeah.
So, what are you gonna perform here, Heather?
Okay, so this is a song called It's Over, and like our friend Varros here, I love a good breakup song, so...
Okay, so,
so
it's...
That's it.
It's over.
That's
so, Heather Pierce, it's over.
Okay, here we go.
BFF.fm, Espresso Sesh, let me put the camera closer to you. So can, my nose is not like on the way. All right.
Okay.
So we got it. You ready?
Sure.
Let's go. Okay. BFF.fm. It's over. Heather Pierce live.
Okay. Here we go.
Live BFF.fm. So this was thank you also, Andrew, for
yes,
holding the mic.
Yeah, we all work together.
Exactly. Yeah, because you know what you hear is what you get, and also what you see is what you get. Espresso Sesh.
Yeah.
Cool. Nice. So this was an original composition that came like with the same process like Andrew was telling before, like you transferring the emotions.
Yeah, and also truthfully, like I said, I haven't really been playing guitar to accompany myself for a super long time. So it was like, oh, what chords do you know?
Okay.
You know what I mean? And that's the other challenge is like I've written so much in collaboration with people. My old band was electronic based, so I was very used to writing to loops and stuff like that, which is super fun too. But I was like, well, what if it was just me in a room and what do I have? And so I have my voice and whatever I knew at the time on guitar. And so I was like, let's try to make something.
Cool. No, it's good that you challenge yourself, like, and, you know, even if you are, like, good in something, like, it's good to, like, step out and try to do something that you are not good at and like, learn and be better.
Yeah, and it's fun.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun.
And I think that's important when, you know, when you make your life in music, you, it's not that, I mean, of course, the reason you wanted to do that is because you love it, but anything can become work if you're doing it all the time and you're on the grind and the hustle and whatever. And so I feel like it helps me reconnect with the joy of like why I loved singing when I was, you know, 2 years old.
Yeah.
It's just like making the sound and feeling it. So
helps keep the motivation going,
yeah,
no, in the
exactly.
routine, throughout the routine of like everyday life.
Yes.
Cool. Yeah, we agree with that, and yeah, we support to like break the routine and do something different.
Yeah.
Cool. So like you brave to like go and perform on guitar if you don't feel comfortable, but you still do it. So
why not?
Cool. So you're gonna play another song.
Yeah. Okay. So
what is next?
So the next song is a cover, and when I started learning, it's been about a year and a half, and it was actually one of my other clients is an amazing guitar teacher, and so I said to him, I was just like, hey, Dave, you know, I just don't bombard me with, like, 8,000 scales and all the classical stuff, and, like, I appreciate it, much respect, but, like, that's not what I'm going for here, like, I just want to play a damn song. And also, to give myself a break, I wanted to play something that I wasn't, like, super, like, intensely connected to, where I was going to put all this pressure on myself. Though, and I'm not saying this in a bad way, I absolutely love pop radio, but I was like, I'm just going to play something that I'm not like, oh my God, if I don't learn this song, it's going to ruin me. And so, this song is called Wide Awake, and it's by Katy Perry. And what's been really fun is just realizing that a lot of these, like, very hit popular songs are not made of 1,000 chords. And it's just kind of more like what the artist did lyrically and expressively. And now I've, like, really come to love the song. I think it's a great tune. And
Because, you know, pop music usually is it's kind of simple because it has to be catchy. It has to
be wide,
it has to reach the widest audience possible. So,
yeah.
You know, if you start complicating things, it gets complicated for the listener, right?
Yeah.
So, Wide Awake, Ed appears.
We'll see what happens. Yeah, supposedly it's simple, but you know.
Like, yeah, let's go.
Give me a break. If I mess up, give me a break. Okay.
Yes. If you mess up, like I'm gonna like switch your mic off.
Okay,
so,
perfect.
Okay, so you're gonna pretend to
play. I'll absolutely just leave.
Okay. Thank you. All right. There we go. Like Ed appears.
All right.
Wide Awake live BFF.fm.
All right. One more time.
Yeah.
Here we go. I was in I wish I knew then what I know now. Wouldn't dive in, wouldn't bow down. Gravity hurts, you made it so sweet. Till I pulled up, up on the concrete. I'm falling from cloud nine. Crashing from the high. I'm letting go tonight. Yeah, I'm falling from cloud nine. I'm wide awake.
Live BFF.fm, Heather Pierce, cool, nice.
Thank you.
There's a pop song,
yeah.
Like nowadays song,
exactly.
Stripped down to a, like a acoustic arrangement.
Yeah.
Cool, like daring the territories that are not familiar with,
Yeah.
That is nice, okay. Would you like to sing another song?
That's actually all I have prepared on the live front.
On the live front.
I'm happy to like throw you a track, inspirational track.
Inspirational track, okay.
Yeah, how about that?
Sounds good, yeah, it's up to you, yes.
Okay.
It's also like 3:50 here, we have live, so we have like the last, that's why we have, time is running, it's time to, like, we have like 5 minutes of live show left.
Okay.
But let's talk, like before you play the song, let's talk about your song salon and your vocal coach once again.
Yes, absolutely. So song salon is an event that happens mostly monthly with my studio. And actually it's happening this Friday and I'm joining forces with a wonderful collaborator. Mimi, who owns Giggling Lotus Yoga over in the Dog Patch. So we're actually kind of taking it up a notch and we're going to combine yoga and song salon because we really want to tap into dealing with performance anxiety. And so I actually go to this yoga studio myself. And Mimi's going to lead us through some meditation. We're going to talk about creating anxiety release rituals before you get on stage. And then we're also going to have everybody, you know, play their respective pieces, give creative feedback. But we want to kind of just get into an even more, you know, mystical portal with just expressing ourselves and working on our craft. And I think this is going to be a fun way to do that.
And it's gonna happen for the first time, like on the, you
yeah,
say, on this,
exactly.
On the 10th, no?
March
10th.
So it's happening on March 10th from 6:30 to 9 at Giggling Lotus Yoga on 3rd Street in the Dog Patch. You can go to my website, heathervox.com. And you can click on the workshops tab and that will take you to all of the information. You can follow me on Instagram too at Heather Vox, Heather V-O-X. That is the Latin word for voice. That is why I use it. people are like, why? That's why. And then of course I have my own private vocal coaching practice where I work one-on-one with other singers, and also I do go in and kind of help bands deal with different things, backup harmonies, lead singer, whatever. I do a lot of in-studio tracking, like Varros and I were in the studio tracking with him a lot, and it's so much fun. And then even some professionals that use their speaking voice a lot and get fatigued from it. I help them deal with the ups and downs of that too. So, yeah.
So cool. Feel free to contact Erin, heathervox.com for
available
any,
on Skype as well. So you don't have to be an SF.
Any related vocal related stuff.
Yes.
Goes to Erin. Thank you, Ellen.
Thank you.
So what you brought for music that was inspirational for you?
Yeah. So, you know, obviously I'm going to pick a voice that I love. And this is when I was a little kid, my parents blasted Donna Summer in the house. And when I probably was like 2 or 3, I don't know. But the song I Feel Love is one of my absolute favorites. And one thing that I think is super cool, this is from 1977, and it's really, really groundbreaking because she and her producer, I believe
Giorgio
Moroder. So what's super cool though that about this tune is that he was like really experimenting with sequencers instead of like string arrangements for disco, right? And it became a huge disco hit, but I feel like it's also, you know, kind of a pioneering electronic song as well, because it's got that 4/4 timing and the heavy bass line and drums and then just that like absolutely immaculate female vocal. And Donna Summer was just exquisite, her vocal tone and everything about her. So,
and I think this is gonna be the last track for today.
Okay, cool.
So thank you so much for being here.
Thank you having me and all of us.
Thank you, Heather. Thank you, Andrew Varros. Thank you, the Blue Hours. They left the building.
Yes,
already.
They left the building.
But you guys stay tuned on BFF.fm, because after us there is gonna be the Astral Projection Radio Hour at 4 sharp. So this is going to be, thank you so much, Heather again.
Check them out.
You got the links.
Yep.
And stay tuned on BFF.fm. And let's close this show with this I Feel Love by Donna Summer. And Giorgio Moroder is going to be in a few seconds. And thank you so much for listening. See you next time.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Yo. Ciao. See you next week.